Pranav, if I rephrase your question to mean that you're saying if I think of the future, then it appears like slavery of the past, because future emerges from the images of the past. But at the same time, there is a fear that if I do not think of the future, from where will my action come? From where will my action come? Right? But it's actually simple, not at all complicated, if we look at it carefully. Future is automatically, naturally flowing from the present. At this moment, several of us, it is evident from your faces, are listening carefully, right? You are still listening carefully. In this process of listening, you are not thinking, not planning, just listening. You are just present. And future is being created. Have we not moved through time in the last 2 minutes? Even as you listen to me, is future not happening? Moment by moment, are we not moving into the future? We are, we surely are. And that is happening on its own, without needing any interference from our side. But what do we think? Our usual conception is that unless I create a future, future will not come. Correct? Our conception is that unless I create a future, future will not come. Or let me put it this way, unless I create a beautiful future for me, there would be no beauty in the future. Is that more correct? Is that the real thing?
Yes.
That unless I create a beautiful future for me, there would be no beauty in the future. That's how we think, correct? Now my question to you is, going back to the example we are taking, is not a beautiful future, considering this moment, even the next second is future, the next minute is future, the next hour is future. Consider this second itself, which is very much available to us. Are we not constantly moving into the future? Peacefully, without any effort. It's cool, no problems, no effort, just presence, just attention. Let me take another example. Let's have a seed with us. Let's have a seed with us. The seed's nature is to grow into a tree, correct? It is the seed's very nature to grow into a tree. You do not require to imagine a future so that the seed becomes a tree. What do you require? You just require that in the present moment you are with the seed, that you take care of it, you give it sunlight, water, nourishment, and that will happen if you love the seed. The equation goes seed plus air plus water plus soil is equal to tree, correct? But in your mind, the equation has another variable. In your mind, the variable is seed plus air plus water plus desire is equal to tree. You feel that unless I desire this seed to become a tree, how will it become a tree? It will become a tree on its own. The present will become future on its own. You just take care of the seed. You just take care of the present. Future will come on its own. A beautiful tree will be born. A beautiful future will be born. You just take care of the present. You just take care of the seed. Is 2 plus 2 is equal to 4?
Yes.
But you know what you say? You say 2 plus 2 plus desire is equal to 4. I want 2 plus 2 to be 4. If you have clarity, if you are looking at it correctly, then 2 plus 2 would naturally be 4. Do you want to desire it to be 4? There is no need. All you need is appropriateness in looking at 2 plus 2, and it will by itself come out to be 4. It does not need your interference because it is 4. A beautiful present is a beautiful future because future is nothing but the present. The present of the next moment is the future of this moment, is it not? Is it not? So don't feel guilty, Pranav, at all that you are neglecting the future. In fact, if you are thinking that you are neglecting the future, you are still thinking about the future. Still obsessed with it. Achha, in this also, there is a slight misconception that needs to be corrected. We all have the ability to forecast. Forecasting is one thing, and desiring something from the future is another thing. You see, based on how the economy is going, an economist can forecast what will be the production next year, correct? That is also looking into the future, but that is not the same as being future oriented. We become future oriented. You have the weather department. What does it do? It keeps forecasting the weather. That is one thing, that I have the capacity to project a particular future. That is one thing. But to be obsessed with the future is an entirely different thing. Entirely different thing. To make the future the center of your action is totally different. There are two ways of acting. One is, I am acting right now and out of this the future comes. The other is, I already have an image of the future in my mind and based on that image, I am working in the present. Unfortunately, 99% of us work according to the second model. See, the first model says, I am in love with my books. I study in the present, and because I study well in the present, hence I will surely do well in the exams in the future. This is the second model. The first model says, when the examinations will be announced, when the exam date sheet will be put up, then to do well in that exam, I will start studying. To take care of that future, I will start studying in the... That is the way of our life. That is the way of the life of 99% people. Future comes first for you and then present comes from there. Which is an absurd thing. You are reversing the flow of time. What comes first? Present or future? Present. But in our minds, future comes first. We say that that's where we want to go. Hence, today I must be here. We want to succeed in that exam, so today I must study. The appropriate way of living is, because today I am studying, hence I will naturally do well in any exam. I am not studying for the sake of the exam. I am studying because I am studying because yes. Won't it be beautiful if you could live this way? Yes. Yes. Then marks would just be a byproduct. Maybe you will not top, but you will get sufficient marks. We anyway don't top. Not all of us are toppers over here. But you will get nice, decent enough marks. Marks won't matter. What would matter is the time that you spent with the books, the enjoyment, the thrill, the fun that was there. getting it?
So it means we can say that we should not be bothered about the direction in which the future is coming.
Lovely. Feel free. Let it come. Fearlessly. That was the topic in the morning, right? Fearlessly let it come. Have a deep faith that I am capable of handling whatever will come. As they say, aren't they? Bring it on, man. I can take it. Bring it on. I'm not afraid. Not scared. Not shivering. Just bring it on. Let it come. I have the wherewithal to respond to it. My intelligence is adequate. There is a challenge, I'll respond. Yes? The world is not a threatening place, please. We think that unless we secure ourselves well, the future can harm us, right? That's what we think. That if we do not secure ourselves well, there may be some danger in the future. Correct? And to take care of that danger, we must wear some kind of armor. We enclose ourselves. Right? That's what we do. The world is not a dangerous place. Had the world been a dangerous place, how could you have been born? The very fact that you are here means that existence has no enmity with you. This air that is available for breathing, did you plan to get this air, beta? Does existence have enmity with you? You can hear, you can see, you have become young. Your arms are powerful, you have energy. Did this come to you because you asked for it? Because you desired it? Yes? Do your eyes have eyesight because you desired it? Existence has given this all to you. How can existence be hostile towards you? Past was not hostile. The present is not hostile. How can the future be hostile? Why are you so afraid? You understand hostility. What is hostility? Enmity. Dushmani. ये सब कुछ जो है अगर इसको तुमसे दुश्मनी होती तो तुम क्या बचे रह सकते थे? इतनी सी तुम्हारी जान है. एक अभी आएगा मीटियोराइड और खत्म हो जाना है. एक छोटी सी टेम्परेचर रेंज में हम जिंदा रह सकते हैं. उससे ऊपर टेम्परेचर हो गया तो हम खत्म हो जाएंगे. उससे नीचे हो गया तो हम ठंड से मर जाएंगे. एग्जिस्टेंस तुमको सब फेवरेबल कंडीशंस दे रहा है. दे रहा है कि नहीं दे रहा है? इसी एयर में अगर नाइट्रोजन 78% की जगह 98% हो जाए तो अभी खत्म हो जाएंगे ना हम सब. दुनिया क्या बात है, हमारी दुश्मन है. गौर से देखो ना, है क्या? तुम कहोगे दुनिया दुश्मन नहीं, दूसरे लोग दुश्मन है. दूसरे ही लोगों ने चलना सिखाया. ये जो भाषा है जो मैं अभी बोल रहा हूं और आप सुन रहे हो, ये भाषा भी दूसरे ही लोगों की दी हुई है. ये पेपर है, इसका आविष्कार भी ना आपने किया ना मैंने किया, ये भी दूसरे ही लोगों ने दिया है. ये पंखा, ये कैथोड रे, ये कपड़े, ये सब दूसरों ही लोगों की ईजाद की हुई चीजें हैं. तो दूसरे भी हमारे दुश्मन कैसे हो गए? Essentially, in all planning for future, Pranav, there is a fear of future.